Welcome back. Let's talk about CMMC Level 2 Scoping Guidance. The DoD CIO published a CMMC Level 2 Scoping Guide. Let's walk through a scoping diagram to learn about the guide. As a reminder, the CMMC assessment scope includes all assets in the contractor's environment that will have the security requirements applied to them, be assessed, and/or documented. For CMMC Level 2, assets that process, store, or transmit controlled and classified information, and assets that provide security protections for those CUI assets must have the security controls applied to them. This diagram is used to show where the CUI assets are and to differentiate between the other asset types. This diagram is also used during scoping discussions with a third-party assessor, and it's also included in the SSP. In this example, FCI is processed, stored, or transmitted on the CUI assets. In other words, we haven't put FCI assets into a separate assessment scope. The CUI assets also hold FCI. The blue-colored items are CUI assets and are in scope. CUI assets process, store, or transmit CUI and are also authorized to hold both CUI and FCI. The purple-colored items are security protection assets and are also in scope. Security protection assets provide security protections for CUI assets. The green-colored items are contractor risk-managed assets, or CRMAs. CRMAs are in scope, but they're only required to be documented. Contractor risk-managed assets should be sufficiently documented, showing that there are policy, procedures, or technical measures in place to prevent CUI from reaching these assets. If the assessor believes the contractor's policies, procedures, or technical measures to prevent CUI from reaching these assets are insufficient, the assessor might assess them just to be double sure. Specialized assets are in scope but are only required to be documented. They include assets that may or may not process, store, or transmit FCI or CUI. The red-colored items are out-of-scope assets. They cannot process, store, or transmit CUI because they are physically or logically separated from the CUI assets or are inherently unable to do so. Let's dig into this diagram. The items on the left in red are out of scope. Notice how they are logically separated from the in-scope boundary. In the CMMC assessment scope, the contractor boundary includes multiple asset types. It shows a purple lock and safe, which are considered security protection assets. These assets contribute to the physical security requirements of CMMC. There are also contractor risk managed assets in green. Let's say the system in green is the contractor's internal ticketing system, and they have implemented data loss prevention or DLP technology to prevent CUI from being uploaded into the system. They also have a policy against uploading CUI into the ticketing system, along with a banner inside of the system itself. Below that, you see CUI assets, which includes a person and a database. Finally, there are some specialized assets at the bottom. Now let's look at the cloud service provider section. In this case, the defense contractor is leveraging a cloud service provider to process, store, and transmit FCI and CUI. Let's say the cloud they're using is Microsoft 365 GCC High. Microsoft 365 would be in scope and the CMMC Level 2 requirements would need to be applied to it. Because the Microsoft cloud is used to process and store CUI, the DFAR 7012 FedRAMP moderate equivalent requirement would also be triggered. At the time of this recording, Microsoft 365 GCC High is in process to achieve a FedRAMP High authorization, which actually exceeds the requirements of FedRAMP Moderate. There is shared responsibility when using a cloud computing service between the cloud provider and the end user. The defense contractor should take care to ensure they implement their portions of the CMMC requirements. So no, just buying GCC High isn't enough. You'll still have to secure the environment and take care of your portions of the shared responsibility. Below that, there are contractor risk managed assets in green. This could be the contractor's cloud-based timekeeping system. Now let's look at the external service provider section. The defense contractor has outsourced management of its IT services to a managed service provider called Bob's IT Shop. Bob's IT Shop manages the defense contractor's network and cloud environment. For CMMC Level 2, Bob's IT shop would be considered a security protection asset because it manages and secures the IT environment. Put another way, Bob's IT shop provides security protections for the CUI assets. Bob's IT shop also meets the definition of an external service provider because it provides comprehensive IT management services and security protection data is processed, stored, or transmitted onto Bob's assets. This external service provider designation means that Bob's IT shop must obtain CMMC Level 2 certification as well. The CMMC requirement for Bob's IT shop would actually be driven by their agreement with the defense contractor. If the contractor went into a CMMC assessment and Bob's IT shop wasn't certified, the contractor would fail their assessment. Pick your MSPs and MSSPs wisely. Here is a scope diagram with a table showing what needs to be done for each asset category. For CUI and security protection assets, we must implement the CMMC requirements, document them in the SSP, network diagram, and asset inventory. For specialized and contractor risk managed assets, we must document them in the SSP, boundary diagram, and asset inventory. Contractor risk managed assets should be documented in the SSP, boundary diagram, and asset inventory. They should be sufficiently documented, showing that there are policies, procedures, or technical measures in place to prevent CUI from reaching these assets. Out of scope assets should only be shown on the network diagram. You'll need to demonstrate that these assets are physically or logically separated from the CUI assets. All right, let's summarize. The purpose of CMMC scoping is to determine which assets require the implementation of the security requirements, which assets will be assessed, and which assets will be documented. CUI and security protection assets are in scope. They must be documented and must have the CMMC requirements applied to them. Contractor risk managed assets are in scope, but are only required to be documented. As I mentioned before, if the assessor believes the contractor's policies, procedures, or technical measures to prevent CUI from reaching these assets are insufficient, they may still be assessed. Specialized assets are also in scope, but are only required to be documented. Out-of-scope assets are not required to be assessed or documented. Contractors still should document them in the network diagram to demonstrate that they are physically or logically separated from the CUI assets. CUI and security protection assets that are hosted by external providers expand the contractor's CMMC scope. If the contractor is leveraging a cloud service that is a CUI asset, they must ensure it is at least FedRAMP moderate equivalent and address their portions of the CMMC security requirements. If the contractor is outsourcing the management of their IT services to an MSP and the MSP meets CMMC's definition of an external service provider or ESP, the MSP would need to be CMMC Level 2 certified in order for the defense contractor to pass a CMMC Level 2 certification assessment. Also note that an MSSP could be considered an ESP and require CMMC certification as well. All right, that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one.